Good evening, everyone. I've been dying to test out the Astrophotography Timelapse feature of the Google Pixel 4 since Google has announced it. But for the last few weeks, it's been cloudy nights after cloudy nights. And finally tonight, there's a night without too many clouds. So I'm just gonna wait another half an hour to see if it's a good night or not. But if it is, we're gonna go out in the middle of the lake and take some pictures and test this feature out. For those of you who are new to this channel, I'm Bellemare-Alford, a young photographer and filmmaker on a journey to become better at this art. It's currently 10:30 p.m. and I just went inside to get my gear because I think it's going to be the right night to test out this feature. So now let's go out on the lake and really test it out. I'm super excited about this one. Okay, so I started stressing quite a lot while getting here because I could clearly see some clouds coming in. So I rushed with my kayak, jumped outside, took my tripod, took my Google Pixel 4 and started taking pictures right away. So I already saw the results and they're pretty cool. So now let's set everything up so you can see how to take these pictures too. Okay, so now that the camera is on the tripod, we're ready to go and test this out. So if you haven't changed already, go on night sight. The next thing, you want to go inside of the settings and just check a few things. So first of all, we're going to go here and make sure that we have astrophotography on auto. You don't want to have it off, so just make sure it's on auto. Then you can go in your settings here and then go in advanced, and you want to make sure that enable time lapse for astrophotography is enabled. By default, it is already enabled for you, so it shouldn't be a problem at all, but just make sure that it's actually okay before getting started. So now we're going to go back and we're ready to try and compose our shots. So I'm just going to bring it up a little bit more to get more sky inside of the photo. Then I might turn it a little bit more over here. Move it up again. And now that we're ready, we're simply going to wait for a second for the camera to realize that astrophotography is on. So now astrophotography is on. So now we're ready to click and to take the shot. So now we're going to wait for the full 4 minutes to get the final results. If you want to learn more on how to take pictures of the stars using your phone, I have another video that completely talks about that. And I also have a few other videos on how to take time lapses using your phone of the stars. So definitely go check those out if you want to learn more advanced techniques. But this one is all automated, so we're going to see the results in 4 minutes. So now we just have to wait. Okay, so 15 seconds left, 10 seconds left, so we're gonna see the results really, really soon. So 3, 2, 1, it's done. So now if we come in our shot right here, it's probably still processing a little bit, so we're just gonna wait a second for it to finish processing. So now we have our photo just like we're used with the astrophotography mode on the Google Pixel phones. But now if we look right here, we're gonna have a video. And if we click on play right here, we have our little time lapse. So it's only 1 second, which was a little bit disappointing. I was expecting something a little bit longer, but it's because it only takes the pictures that it was taking while it was taking the astrophotography shot to create this time lapse. So I would like if Google let us take something longer and get a longer time lapse, but it's definitely a nice little thing to have when you're taking an astrophotography shot. Okay, so now let's try and take a few other shots because we're in the middle of Milky Way season, so there's probably a pretty good shot to get up that. So now let's set it up. Okay, so based on photo peels, the Milky Way should be right behind here, so I have my cell phone set up right here, so now we're ready to take this shot and see if we can see it or not. Okay, so we just got our first preview right here after 15 seconds, and it looks like we can see quite well the Milky Way, so I'm really excited to see how it's gonna look like in the final result with the little time lapse. Okay, so 5 seconds left, it just completed. So now let's go and see the result right here. So we have the picture that is processing right now. And now if we look at the little time lapse right here, okay, so this is pretty cool. So now we have the Milky Way that is moving around, and you can really see it really well in this picture. So this is really cool, having a little time lapse of the Milky Way using only your Google Pixel 4a. Okay, so before going back home, I wanted to quickly talk about my final thoughts of this time-lapse feature for the Google Pixel 4a. So the first thing is that it only works with the most recent Google Pixel phone, so it's a Google Pixel 4 and above. So that's a little bit disadvantage if you have an older model and it doesn't support it. The second thing that is a little bit annoying is that you're really limited to the 1 second output, which I think is just not quite long enough. It would be nice to have something a little bit longer, but the effect overall is pretty cool. And one thing I discovered is that it works much better if you have a foreground. So I tried taking only the stars. And when I did that, the result just wasn't as good because you don't really have a reference of something that's not moving inside of the frame to really show you that the stars are moving a lot more. So definitely try getting a foreground when taking these shots to get a better effect overall. If you enjoyed this video, please let me know by hitting the like button below, and also consider subscribing for more content on photography and filmmaking. See you in the next one. Bye bye.